Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and many of you have been asking me, what's the difference between the iPhone 11 Pro and the iPhone 11 Pro Max? So I wanted to go over what's the same and also go over what's different. So the first thing is the price. Between the two of these, the iPhone 11 Pro is $100 cheaper. So for every configuration that you have, for example, with the iPhone 11 Pro versus the Pro Max, the price starts at $999 with the 11 Pro and goes up to $1,349. And this is US dollars, so it could vary depending on the country you're in. If you want the Pro Max or the larger size, you'll have to pay an additional $100 for the same configuration. So for example, you can get 64 gigabytes, 256 gigabytes, or 512 gigabytes of storage. Each one of those is $100 more on the iPhone 11 Pro Max than it is on the 11 Pro. So prices go from $1,099 to $1,449 on the 11 Pro Max. Now, when it comes to the colors, the iPhone 11 Pro and Pro Max have the exact same color option. You have this space gray. You also have this new midnight green color that we have here on the 11 Pro, as well as a silver and a gold color as well. So those are four options. You can get the exact same on all of them. Both of these phones are built the exact same. They're stainless steel around the outside edge, and then they have glass back and front. So there's glass on both of them, on both the backs and front. And the glass is more durable as far as drops, but it's more prone to scratches, it seems, on the surface layer. So you want to make sure you have a screen protector on it if you're worried about getting scratches and things like that. Just like I have here, you want to make sure you have a screen protector if you're worried about that. If not, and you have Apple Care, then you're fine. Now, the most obvious difference between the two is the size. On the left, the iPhone 11 Pro has a 5.8-inch display, and that's measured from here to here. It's a 5.8-inch display, 2,436 by 1,125 pixels, with a density of 458 pixels per inch. The same pixel density is on the iPhone 11 Pro Max, but because it's a larger display at 6.5 inches, it has a higher overall pixel resolution of 2,688 by 1,242, and again, 458 pixels per inch. Due to the size, there's an obvious weight difference, and the iPhone 11 Pro weighs 6.63 ounces or 188 grams, whereas the iPhone 11 Pro Max weighs 7.97 ounces and 226 grams. Now, also due to that size, we have different battery sizes. The iPhone 11 Pro has a 3,046 milliamp hour battery, whereas the iPhone 11 Pro Max has a 3,969 milliamp hour battery. Now, with the iPhone 11 Pro, you're going to get about 9 to 10 hours of screen on time with normal use. Depending on how you use it, it could be less or it could be more, and you'll get an additional hour on top of that with the 11 Pro Max. So you can get a little extra. So if you have an iPhone XS Max, for example, the iPhone 11 Pro Max should be about 5 hours more battery life than last year's models and 4 hours more battery life than last year's model with the 11 Pro. So they're both very, very good when it comes to battery. Now, those are all the things that are different. The things that are the same are the CPU, for example. So the actual speed and processor inside of these is the exact same A13 Bionic. They both have the same RAM. They also have the same speakers on the bottom and the top, and they also have the same IP68 water resistance. And then probably the best thing about both of them is they have the same exact cameras and Face ID system on the front and the same triple lens cameras on the back. Now, the cameras on the back are fantastic. They're new 12 megapixel cameras with a wide angle, an ultra wide, and a telephoto lens. And they take great pictures, and they both have night mode. And if you go into photos, you can enable night mode. When you go to video recording, they both have 4K 60 capability, 4K 30 and 4K 24. And the same is true for the forward facing camera. You have the same resolutions for that. So you can see on the left, I have it turned on to 4K 60, on the right 4K 30. And then if I tap on the button here, we can change it to 4K 24. So you have all of those options, and they're all fantastic cameras, and they have really good microphones, and they all have good reception compared to last year. As far as Face ID, it's the exact same on both, so you're not really missing out on anything as far as that goes, and you also get the same fast charger in the box. Inside the box, you've got the same fast charger. This is an 18-watt fast charger, similar to that of the iPad Pro, and it comes with a USB-C to Lightning cable to charge it, so you do get fast charging with both. And that is really it between the both of them. So hopefully that helps you out if you're trying to decide which one of these phones to pick up. The iPhone 11 Pro and Pro Max are both excellent phones, and they both work well, have wireless charging as well, and the only difference really is a slight weight difference, screen size, and battery difference. Other than that, they're identical in every way. But let me know which one you're going to pick up, if you've already picked one up, or if maybe you're going to wait until next year to figure out what you'd like to get. Let me know in the comments below. Or maybe you opted for the iPhone 11 or an older phone. I'd love to hear what you have to say in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.